Hi, friends from Qatar. This is Everton Anunciação. I'm from Brazil, direct from Brazil right now. I hope everything enjoy this important event about digital transformation. I'd like to share my humble acknowledgement experience work with digital transformation since in 1986 in Brazil, South America, and abroad. And it's very important to share about this because we are facing digital transformation around the world. So that's the reason I'm honored to be invited for this talk and share a little my comments and background with all of you. Okay, let's start the conversation. My talk of today, I called this Engineering 2.0. Everything focuses on the customer vision. What do you think about this? When you think, Everton is talking about Engineering, but it was talked 30 years ago. Why bring it back for right now? It's a new version. Is a new tradition, evolution. Digital transformation is about this. You never have to be satisfied in the situation that you are now. If you are a person, if you are a business, or product or service, you always have to be in transformation, evolution. That is the goals of my conversation. I'm Everton Anunciação. I was born and live in Brazil. This year, it has been a very good year for me. I'm among the greatest guy in customer service, customer experience, with many awards I received this year. And I hope you can enjoy in my network in LinkedIn. Then we can talk more about my books, my consulting, my talks, always to bring organic transformation, not just a piece of the body of the organization, but organic, all complete transformation for a long-term transformation. Before I decide to see the Qatar and Doha city transformation, as I said, everything has to be prepared for transformation. For example, you can see here view of Doha in 1980s, showing the Sheraton Hotel in West Bay Area. You can see how it was in 1980s. Now, you can see the same view in 2021. And you can see all this beautiful view. And now Doha is considered one of the best cities in the world. Quality of living, technology. So, if all the city was transformed, why we as a business and professional has to be stopped? No. Transformation is regarded human being, in all the history. Just who transformed themselves can survive in the history. That's the point. So, and transformation of the business, how the point your business, your career, your profession has to be transformed. The accommodation, when you stop somebody else in your side, could be a person, another professional, another business, is transforming to get your space, to get your customer, to get your opportunity. So, it's the same for the business. So, remember in 1980s, we talk about engineering that I call 1.0, where and when everything focuses on the product. So, the traditional, the company developed a product, developed a service, but they did not bring the customer in the middle of the project. So, the industry, the dream of the industry was, oh my God, I want to develop a product, identify the process, review, design, test, implement, just in the market. But the customer was not in the middle, just the product, the concept of the product. They always have passion for the product, not for the customer view. So if you remember better, you can see most of the company fell in love for standard, for a stamp of standard. Oh, I'm ISO 9001, I have the certified, I'm certifying that, certifying this. That was the passion. My product is certified. Don't matter if the customer accept this experience to receive this product. That's the difference point. So that put in mind that we were talking about Engineering 1.0 in almost 30 years ago, 40 years ago. Now, what I bring for reflection is we have to adapt the self. All the customers that was in the past adapt themselves for the product offered for the marketing. You have to broke, or we already broken this wall, not to think more in product and services. Because most of the, because most of the product now, they are service, not just product. Because I'm buying the experience to have that product. I'm having the experience to use this product. But the product is not the goal. It's my experience with relationship with this company, with the service of this company. That's the main difference that we want to talk. Now, when I bring a new concept called Engineering 2.0, I try to make prove that everything focuses on the customer experience and the customer perspective. I put the customer in the middle. That's the difference. What this mean? So the main, if I could brief a little all this comment that is a long term term, but I could bring a brief. The brief is not focused in product, but in customer journey. You have to map and identify all touch points of the customer in the company, all the data that we collect in each touch point, all the information, knowledge, wisdom that we get when the customer interacting with the company, with our employee, with our digital technology. So we have to focus on customer journey, not in product. But it will not be important if we do not collect the proper data within each contact channel. What the customer is saying for us as a manager or an entrepreneur. So in this Engineering 2.0, all customers define the specific needs and journey once they interact with the company. Product and service are redefined constantly by the customer wish. So my company, day by day, is redefined by customer wish. That's the goal. So Engineer 2.0, where and how to start? Imagine that you are like this map. You are analogic and want to go digital. Okay, to find the treasure, we have to follow some steps. Could be 80, could be 5, depend the speed of the business, depend the speed of the all employee and the culture of the company. For example, let me bring some question for you. How your company is ready for real-time decision? Think about that.
So you're gonna be like this all night?
Like what?
Lauren, look,
Stop. I don't want to talk about this here.
Why not?
I just don't feel comfortable discussing it here. I don't want somebody listening in.
There's nobody listening in.
Well, you never know.
Lauren, this is ridiculous. Would you just talk to me? I don't know what to say. I don't know what we should do.
What do you mean you don't know what we should do? Why are you being like this?
Why do you always have to throw it back at me like that? Like everything's always...
I'm not throwing it back
at you. Yes, you are.
Can we just please talk like adults for once?
Well, if it were up to me, we wouldn't even be having this conversation. Can we just get the check and go?
Okay, Lauren, I think that you're making this into much more of a big deal than it really is.
How can you say that?
After everything that's happened, that it's not that big of a deal? Really, Jai? Because...
As far as I remember, this is the same conversation that we had 2 months ago.
I understand why this is happening. Just think things are so black and white, but it's not always that simple.
I don't see what's complicated about this.
Okay, fine. Tell me, Lauren, what do you think we should do? What do you want?
I don't know.
Really? Your answer, I don't know?
After everything, this is what it comes down to? This?
First of all,
this is not about me.
Oh, it's not. It's not about you.
You sure about that?
Jesus, Jack, can you grow up and do your
responsibility for once?
This is outrageous. I didn't do anything wrong.
You know what? I'm tired of having the same fight. You tell me you're going to change, but you never do.
I just don't know what to say to you right now.
It looks like we might not even have anything to say to each other.
I'm sorry. I never meant to hurt you. I don't want to lose you over something like this.
Me neither. I'm sorry too. I guess I overreacted.
Can you guess and imagine your business acting like this in real-time decision with all employee, with all process and technology that we are talking about? This is digital transformation. You have to put all your business to decide in real-time decision, in real-time wisdom, digital wisdom. Bring it all together, you know, in short and long-term to decide what the best
is
and your business. So, how can you imagine this? Imagine your business like a relay race and pass the baton. All your process, information, technology, resource, professional, contact channels must be integrated. All is not regard just all IT information department, call center department, sales department, marketing department. All have to run together. Bring all the best customer experience for your customers. That we are talking about. This transformation, you have to pass in the baton in the proper way, in the proper time to continue the run. Then the customer will be going satisfied with your interaction with your company. However, in my view, in your business, you have to end the MMA and war between areas like IT, marketing, sales, customer service, and bring customer and customer for sure. Normally, in this arena or MMA, for example, we always forgot to bring with all main decision IT information, technology information area. No, they have to be together to decide. The information department, the technology department has to stop to be reactive has to be active. They have to be within the business, because most of the company need technology. So we have to think together, not just think about the hard drive, disk, cloud, on-premise, what kind of backup, No, we have to think strategy of the business, how to use technology to think, to satisfy customer, marketing, sales, customer services, all together in the same thing. So IT department professional has to be invited in the beginning of any decision, not just in the end, or make miracle in the end. And please, all the company right now with digital transformation has to show the data. Show me the money, show me the data. All the data, okay, most of the company has no structural data. You have many servers, many systems, and now we have General Data Protection Regulation, and we have IoT devices. All these has to be together, integrated for long term. Why is that? Why you have to run to get all this data integrated? Because as you can see here, some miner looking for gold, 70% of the data scientist time is that data cleaning and preparation. It means, like gold miner, 90% of the time mining is spent drilling for gold. So I have a question for you. How many effort all your employee is suffering or spend time to get the proper gold in your data, to offer a good customer experience for your customer? So if you reduce the effort of get wisdom in your data, faster you can offer a good experience and relationship with your customer and destack your company in the market. That's my point of view. But okay, you have data, the challenge of integrate data, but you have to decide what tools and methodology of a customer experience process you are going to implement your company. I have a book that I try to bring many, for example, needs. There is almost 20 methodologies that you can implement your company. NPS, if you want to be a Disney, like a Disney, if you want to be like a Zoho, no, you want to be like a company like United States, you want to be like Asia, Omonotenasha, Japanese culture, not matter. You have to choose what process methodology you want, or make a mix of all of them to better understand your customer. You have to understand all the tools and methodology to implement a customer experience process. And for sure, you have technology, tools available around the world. Don't matter in which touch point in each moment of interaction of your customer. If for each one of the interaction that your customer and your public has with your company, you have a specific technology nowadays. It could be a cheaper, it could be more expensive, whatever. You have to understand all technology that you can face in each of touch points of your customer with your brand, with your product, with your service, okay? But as I told you, if you have a good integration of data, you will have a 360 degree view of your customer data to get a golden record. Because all of this for the employee or for your customer, you have to reduce the effort to interaction to this customer or employee to get the proper information of your customer within the company. For example, you have to develop a campaign center. If you offer marketing offer with your customer, you have to centralize all the offer in just one CRM or campaign center. Don't matter if a channel is a ATM or e-commerce site, if you have email or a call center or a store. But the interaction, the offer has to be the same. Don't matter the contact channel that the customer is facing with the company. Just in long term, if you build a campaign center or a 360-degree customer data, you can offer a reduced effort experience with your customer. And now, for sure, to digital transformation, you are not going to win if you don't prepare your human resource. Your human resource has to be like a superheroes. You have to give power for them. You have to give acknowledgement. You have to give technology, techniques, process. But you are not going to win if you don't give them more than autonomy. They have to be autonomous to decide what the best for the customer and for company, not to be just a block with low level of autonomy. If you give autonomy, a proper autonomy for your employee, they are going to get the balance, how to get the best for the customer and for the company and for themselves in long term. And then we reduce the turnover. And now, to almost end my talk, because it would be take more than time than that, I give you this comment that you can think about. However, if someday all your technology, process, data fail, relax and put all your business acting like a human being. Just practice the kindness with your customer. Yes, the customer forgive you if you treat him with kindness like a human being. Because sometimes everything go wrong, but if you put your goodwill interaction with your customer, they are going to return, they are going to give feedback to grow with him in relationship. That for me is the real digital transformation with kindness. Think about that. And how to bring kindness. All human being has this. You have to think about this.
Sometimes it's easy to feel like the world's getting harder. But if we look closer, on the news, on the web, on the street, we're anything but unkind. Every day, we hear new stories of people trying to make the world a better place. And together, we can make the world that little bit kinder for all of us. It all starts with just one person, you. The thing about kindness is that it's just about the only thing in the world that doubles when you share it. And it's a fact, backed by science. Studies have shown that if you perform just one random act of kindness a day, you'll not only reduce your stress, anxiety, and depression, but your body is flooded with the same hormones that make you and the person you've helped calmer, healthier, and happier. Serotonin, which heals your wounds, helps you relax and makes you feel good. Endorphins, which reduce pain, and oxytocin, which reduces blood pressure and makes you feel more loving and loved. You'll both be more energized, feel less aches and pains, more confident, and could even live longer. And if other people see you helping someone else, they'll be filled with those same feel-good hormones, meaning they're significantly more likely to pay it forward. Like taking that extra moment to hold the elevator for someone, spotting a coffee for a stranger who's just a few cents short, giving your neighbor a hand with their groceries, even just smiling and meaning it. It doesn't take much, but it can make a huge difference for everyone. Those people you've helped will help other people, and those other people will help even more people. And those random acts of kindness can start a chain reaction that can spread across an entire community, a city, a country, and with enough of us, the world. Now, isn't that the world we all want? And it all starts with one.
So, that is the question. How your technology, how your process, how your employee is practicing kindness and empathy with your customer? If you are doing this all together, yes, your company is in the good direction for digital transformation. because many of customers, they will return. They are going to give the proper feedback if you take time hearing their needs. I invite you to know all my books at Amazon, and I hope you enjoy this conversation. See you next time here in Brazil or in Qatar. Bye.